everyone. I'm Kriti Thapa Roka. I am from Nepal. I'm actually staying in New York from 2011. And I'm working in the hospitality industry and hotel. And I'm also a real estate agent in New Jersey. And today I'm with Anuz and Dipika in the podcast at the end of the day.
It's very interesting, Kriti. You have so many, you are wearing so many hats, right?
If I
said it properly.
Yes, she's not literally wearing hats, but.
So, yes. So you have years of experience in hospitality, hospitality management, travel and tourism sector. And then you're also starting out on your career as a real estate agent.
When I come in 2011 in New York, it was really challenging to get the job, you know. It's some people are really lucky that they get the job according to their qualification. For me, it was hard. So I say, why don't I start with the babysitter? So I started as a babysitter, and it was good paid, and they paid my bill, and everything was done, yeah. So only that way I was starting with a babysitter, yeah. But then I did a babysitter for like 2 years. Babysitter is a good job, you know. But only the problem is your skills are limited in one person, in one house, you know. What your talent you're exposing only to the parents of the children, and the children knows what is your talents are, yeah. But then I feel it like because my background is in from Royal Caribbean International, that's a hospitality industries. So why don't I try in the hotel? So the opening was in the Union Hotel as a housekeeper. And I'm telling you too, because doing as a housekeeper, when I say about housekeeper, people say, oh, yes, she does a housekeeper job. But housekeeper job is also very challenging. It's the art of making a room. So then when I start doing it the first day of my job, I say, oh, I do normal housekeeping in the house. I will able to manage that part. But doing a 14 rooms, 14 beds, and cleaning up those rooms, and vacuuming, it's really very challenging. Your body gets really tired, you know? And I was like, I will able to manage. My husband always say, are you giving up with the job? But it's not giving up. I don't want to give up. Even the small job, I don't want to give up. It's for me, I do want to live the life, how the housekeeper does it. You know, that's make me now I have a very respect for the housekeeper. Now I did my degree, and if I will become a manager, GM or whatever in the hotel industry, I will respect the position, because that's what a backbone of the hotel.
You just mentioned you did a degree. Can you explain what you really did?
I did associate degree in hospitality management and travel and tourism from CUNY. Okay. From Laguria Community College.
So that's a 2 years course?
Yes, it's a 2 years course, but it takes me 3 years.
And why is that?
Yeah, because you work and you go to the college, and it's really tough.
What made you go and join the program?
I actually feel like I want to go to the higher position in the hotel, and I want to know about hospitality. When I started the college after 14 years going back to the college, I was so scared, and I was looking for the person who is older as my age, because so I don't feel shy, because all the young people will be what age? Will be 18, 19 years.
You mean 19, the other students?
Other students, yeah. And then I am after 14 years, and then I went to the college, and when I'm in the classroom, was really big classroom for the business. And I went there, and I see 2-3 faces, like they are older than me. Okay. So it's give me more confidence that, okay, I can make it happen, you know.
So tell us, what did you find different in the way you think about the hospitality business now that you have studied about it? Did that help you in any ways?
It's really helped me so many ways. Like when you study about hospitality, they will teach you how to deal with your clients. They will tell you the way, how the hotel industry work, because one of the toughest industry is a hotel. A hotel is not only one part, it goes with the restaurant, yeah? And then it goes with the rooms, and it goes with all the management, you know? So you get a skill to manage the people with the management in the hotel. And not only that, the hotel industry teach you, even you start your job in hospitality, even you satisfy one client a day, is a big achievement for us. one client a day. And nowadays the hotel, you know, the trip advisor and everywhere, mm-hmm. like you are in the media. Mm-hmm. If you don't satisfy your customer and you cannot make it. And when I'm studying about hotel in the class, when I have to go and present myself, I was very scared to say that I'm a housekeeper. Believe me, I'm telling you true. Mm-hmm. It's like people are going to the students are going to think that I'm a housekeeper. What will be my reputation? I used to think that way, but then I when I start studying about, then I say, what actually I'm selling in the hotel? I'm selling the room. Who are the person making the room? The housekeeper. The product in the hotel is the room. If we don't make the rooms, what the product they are selling it? Mm-hmm. So then I realized that we are the backbone of the hotel. So I'm so happy once I get to even a general manager in the hotel, I know what the housekeeping does. I know what the requirements of the rooms are. And I know what my guest is going to look for in the rooms. So it's actually helped me. And when at the end of my class, I come in forward and say, I'm a housekeeper, but I'm very happy. If I promote to be a director of housekeeper, I do know what the housekeeper does, and I do have respect for them because I already experienced that part.
For the people who want to pursue the career you have been pursuing, mm-hmm. what kind of advices do you want to give out to them?
Take opportunity, whatever you get. Don't think, oh, I'm very qualified, I'm not going to go for the small job. Don't think that. Mm-hmm. Catch the place, catch that opportunity. Even it's a small label, yes. but there is a way you can go. Mm-hmm. Because your skill been seen by the people, then you can tell where you want to go. Maybe you want to start with housekeeper, you want to go to the front desk. And then tell them, and they know what the skills are and how you are good in it. So there's opportunity to get upgrade. So don't think that, don't wait for the higher level positions. Mm-hmm. Always start with the base, one step at a time. I always say it like, you know, step by step, you get through the place where you want to, but you have to set up your goal. If I'm going to stop being as a babysitter, mm-hmm. if I'm not going to set up my goal, I will not promote myself. I will not go further. I will stop and I'm say, oh, I'm getting a lot of money with the babysitter. I'm happy with it. Mm-hmm. So, but I was not satisfied. That's why I keep moving and moving, going forward. Mm-hmm. That's really, I will tell everybody to don't stop, keep achieving, keep learning, and find a way and set up a goal to get what you want, you know? So with that.
What is your goal in terms of your career? Yes, what
goal,
next?
My goal is to be a hospitality manager, mm-hmm. and I want to do that part. I love working with people. I want the happy faces to be seen mm-hmm. when I work. Yes, that's the one.
Yeah, is that the reason why you started your side hustle in real estate business?
Yes, because once I moved in New Jersey 2 years before, and because in the New York the rent are higher. So then not only that, when practically speaking, paying a rent, that house is never going to be yours, you know? So when I say, why don't I buy something smaller, what I can manage, you know? But I cannot afford in New York doesn't mean that I'm going to stay for 5-6 years paying rent. No, so I feel like I will want to move. So I get a house in Jersey City. That's more convenient to come to me in New York to work. And the hustle which I face with the lender and with the realtor to getting the different houses and everything. So then I feel like, why don't I start doing the real estate too? It will be part of my job. It's my part-time job actually. And then I went to the classes in real estate and then I took classes. And then after I applied for my license.
Those of our audience who would like to get in touch with you to seek further advice, would you like to share your email address?
Kriti, Kriti, sellsnj. nj@gmail.com.
Okay, thank you so much, Kriti. It was wonderful having you in our podcast. And yes, I think you want to say something.
Yeah,
I will say my last part. Like, okay. I would love to say that part, being okay. as a real estate agent. Mm-hmm. I will say that real estate cannot be lost or stolen, nor can be carried away. Purchased with the common sense, paid paid for in full and managed with a reasonable care, it's the safest investment in the world.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I say about real estate and hospitality. I will say to all the people, it does not matter how slowly you go, as long as you do not stop. That's really important.
Yes.
Because I work slow, but I achieve my goals. So everybody have to, even though in everyday time, even you give your 1 hour to yourself, being as a selfish person.
Mm-hmm.
So you think about yourself, what I'm doing, what is I should be doing. So that's really help you for your career. That's what I say. Slowly, but make it happen.
And on that very highly encouraging note, we have to say bye-bye from today's episode. Thank you so much for watching. So we will catch you next week. Bye-bye.
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 Hey guys, a quick note. If you have a personal story that you think might be helpful to the newly arriving immigrants in the US, please contact us. We would love to feature you in our podcast. Go to our website, podcast@theendoftheday.com, and write to us by going to the feedback section.
And by the way, if you love this podcast, you can support us with a small donation. Your help will enable us to continue producing more episodes. The link to support our podcast is in the description below.